Bien, chicos, buenas noches. Vamos a comenzar con la actividad que es de introducción al chino, al ruso, a cargo de Turar. Él es nombre de KMSA. Turar.
Ah, sí, estoy aquí. Muchas gracias, Juan.
Gracias por estar aquí con nosotros. Puedes proyectar tus diapositivas y ahí lo dejo con Turar. Turar, tu micro está apagado.
Ah, ok. muchas gracias. Hola, voy a empezar a introducción al ruso. Здравствуйте, давайте начнем. ¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo te sientes hoy? From the chat, could you let's begin in the form of so everyone could write and speak. A principio, ¿cómo te sientes hoy? ¿Podrías enviar en chat o abrir tu teléfono, micrófono y decir? Okay, so let's continue. If you're asking why I'm doing that, I'm doing that so everyone could participate. And after that, when we go to the practice of the language, everyone can participate and communicate. And so you can begin your first step in learning and actually speaking Russian language. Okay. Then our lesson will be concluded from. History was similar to the other language, to the other Russian language, and then I will come to the practice. More formal and informal way of practice, and we will end it from with opportunities to the work and study. So let's continue. So let's start from the video.
Мы говорим на русском языке. Can you hear?
Сейчас я хочу He and the first, some fragments or phrases of the Russian language. And so you could see some first signs and the first information about it. So could someone answer to this question? Why are you interested in learning language, especially Russian one? So I think that the students which are participate, 22 of you, have came there because you are somehow interested or aware of the popularity of Russian language. And what is your current motivation or which is your current interest? So why have you come here actually?
Hello. Could you listen to me? Hi, Tara. I am Melissa. Well, I think in my case, I come today because I think when you learn a new language, you can learn about the culture of the country that you want to visit, probably. So I think the first thing that you need to do is learn about the country and also learning the language in order that you can communicate with the people that live there. And also I think that the Russian language is a little bit different than our language. So I think it's very interesting. I don't know if someone wants to participate also, you can put your hand up and we can listen to you.
Perfecto. Muchas gracias por responder a la respuesta.
Chicos, si quieren, pueden responder en el chat y Turar va a leer sus respuestas. La pregunta es, ¿por qué han venido hoy día a aprender un poco del idioma ruso? ¿No? ¿Cuál es su interés? ¿Por qué están aquí? Esa es la pregunta. Les pedimos, por favor, que sean participativos, como en todas las charlas, porque pues estas charlas son bien interactivas. Por favor, gracias. Okay, we have another answer in the chat box. They say that visit Russia.
Okay. So I see your current motivation. So let's see your slides. So here you could see the top reasons why you should learn Russian language. And the first thing is like the actually wide and area of distribution of French language, Russian language. It is the most popular Slavic language. It is from the Eastern European language, most popular, and it is continent of Eurasia, from Europe till Asia. And then the second reason for you to study language, you could see that Russian language is a very creative one. But it is the morphology of it. Russians are very famous for their specificity. you cannot just say I go to school. You should say like I go to school, I go around the school, I go inside of the school. So you should always specify. You're not just going, you're going by this transport, you're going along this. Crossing the street, so according to the meaning, you would change the prefixes. As you can, for example, the example of the недопить, it is пить, it is drink, it is to drink water or to drink vodka. So you can say overdrink, you can say under overdrink. So Russian language really likes the prefixes, and you can say ходить, go, you can say сходить, you can say переходить, уходить. So уходить, so it is so much prefixes which will specify your meaning. And you could create another word, and everyone will understood you, because they're all common list of the prefixes, and they're used in specific situations. And as one, Russian is as close to the other Slavic language as Polish, Czech, Ukrainian, Belarus, and at some point to Kazakh and other Soviet languages also, because it was a difference of large Russian language during the history. And this last one, this last, you could see there are almost no dialects in Russia. We'll also talk about it. And yes, no dialects. Like, if you can see, for example, to the Spanish one, you can see that a separate Chilean, but is Chilean, Argentinian, Mexican, even Peruan. So every country has else dialect, but specifically of the Russian language, that doesn't have any dialects. Maybe very rare, but you had unified the model of this language. And I will personally add the fifth reason, that Russian girls are very beautiful. Okay, so let's continue. As you could see, Russian is language of the official language of United Nations 5 member states, 16 countries, but officially it is used in 5 of them. Then it is one of the 6 official United Nations language, and it is 7th largest this is 7th language according to the number of the speakers, both native one and the non-native one. So as you could see here, 258 million total speakers worldwide. It is at the 7th place after English, Chinese, Hindi, French, Arabic, Portuguese, and Spanish. So as you can see here, so 5 of them, I mean in blue, they are colored. So it's countries where Russian English is official and it is used everywhere, even in Kazakhstan. It is our not state language, but it is a country where I am from. So it is here. And 85% of our population speaks in it. And the native, it's a greenish one. It is population, but it's not registered as official one. So it is not used in the documentaries. So the peculiarities of the Russian language. The peculiarity of Russian language is that it has only 33 letters, in the alphabet, you can see three genders, masculine, feminine, and neutral, according to the endings. So it's much easier to differentiate if we compare with French. And there is no articles. Actually, there is no difference between I go drink a coffee or I drink the coffee. So no actual difference in language. You can say both, and the Russians are, they do not distinguish. It's without indefinite or definite things. The word order is quite, it's also free. You can just say in which, in every order, if you wish you, or which you want. And also, I want to point that there is no diphthongs, so you would pronunciate only by the letters. So let's come to the history, but brief history of the Russian language. So it will be, I think it will be very begin from the ancient times. Russian language are used by the Eastern Europe, and at that time it was like Slavic language. Everyone could understand it from Novgorod in the south, in the north, till the Belgrade or Greece in the north, in the north, in the south. So actually, Russian language or Rus, or Rus de Kiev, was actually the capital of modern Ukraine, and especially the place at the south was called Rus, Kiev Rus, and Novgorod was a and the other cities were like separate republics. And if you want to go to the Rus, you would go to most probably to the Kiev Rus. And as you can see here, it is the orders of the Kyrillic alphabet. Kirill and Metodi. Interesting fact is that they are not even Slavic people. They were from Byzantia, Byzantine Empire, and they were Greek. And they have created this alphabet specifically for the Slavic people so they can easily read the Bible. We could see here the initial or beta version of the Russian language. After that, it was like slightly changed. It is more visible, it's more likely as now, so you could see. And why would you say, and so the question of initial, from the initial questions, you could say why in a such huge area. Yes, we could see that there were some dialects, or maybe not dialects, but slang. So you could see here Novgorod slang, it is with blue, and the Vladimir's. And by the 15th, see that. Polish government has defended Russia, and so Kiev, and it has the Kievan Rus was occupied, or like it was terrorized. So, and the western part of the Kievan Rus was under the Polish influence. So in future we could see the formation of the Ukrainian language and the Belarusian language, and from the dimers, and I mean the blue and the greenish one, has formulated our Russian language. And there is the answer, like why this language actually started from Kiev, but nowadays in Ukraine one speak, I mean not no one, but the nation as Ukrainians speak the separate language, not common language with Russia. And then we would come like, okay, to the 18th century, and Russian alphabet. And you could see here that it is Piotr the First started the Westernization in Russia. Russian language could be more familiar to our to the modern standards, and as you could see here, from and it and Peter the First, many terms were adapted from the most popular language at that time, French, like, I mean, writing, letters of love, dancing, fikhtovanie, and all other stuff were just adapted French to Russian, to Russian, and the majority of business or formal Russian language were built from it was actually the time when Russians had defeated the Napoleon in 1812. So most of the elite and the policemen have great pronunciation. Even in France, they were defined as native speakers. So everything changed, collapsed actually in 1918. When the Soviets come, and it was like revolution, and because of that, Russian language has changed completely, so the Soviet government could control not only physically, but not mentally, but so they could build a new society with new usage of the language. So they changed it, not completely, but they have given new standards of language. And so across the area of the Warsaw Pact and the total USSR, here you could see the distribution of, not formally, but not officially, I mean, but countries of the Warsaw Pact. So propaganda began, and everyone said like "Korotko o pogodě," not any, and they were like fighting from the difference, and they unified the language. So there is no dialects. Everyone will speak as the government approves, actually. So many dictionaries have come, and you could see that I know that you don't know the Kirillic alphabet, but you could see that these two pictures actually differ, yes? Letters are not, so they can unify it, and the Russian dialects have disappeared completely. And this is the last one, Perestroika. I think you all know it is actually the ruin of the Soviet Union. And again, it has huge differences to the language. So many terms were adapted now from English, and the Russian language were enriched with English vocabulary, especially in the IT and the medical sphere. In the medical, here you could see is actually the 15 republics of the USSR, where still you could use Russian language freely and freely communicate with the total population. So let's come to the practice, and I want to first begin with famous Russian words. Which kind of words are familiar to you? Could someone switch my microphone on and tell me? Don't be shy.
Uh-huh. I think could be vodka.
And none of them actually.
Also, there was Sputnik.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's great. Yes, actually, Sputnik, it means also in English. I mean, I remember that it was like most important moment of or moment of your awareness. Like, it's not used like in the meaning of satellite, but it is used more like it is used in the English as another one. So you could see here Matryoshka. It is like Russian doll. You may see it in the films. So it is like a little doll with a nest. Like, so inside of the one, you could see more smaller ones. So in the one, actually big mother, you could see like so many little daughters. And the famous Russian souvenir and a well-known Russian vodka. And the phrase "на здоровье". Actually, no one from Russian speaking names say like "на здоровье" or "cheers", but many tourists, or it was like myth. So everyone thinks that Russian actually say "на здоровье". That's actually true, but however, despite of it, many Russians say, yes, we say "на здоровье", so someone will know some part of their language. And also you could see Yasa Broki, and I think most of you know him. And in English language, you could see the meaning of babushka, or may you hear about it, babushka. And in Russian language, it is used as the granny, grandmother. And in Russia and in the other countries of USSR, grandmothers actually wear the head scarf, and as a Rocky wears. So if the English, or Americans adapted it as scarf, and they say actually it's babushka. And I see that someone said that it was Kumar Ceviche, Kiro Kumar, okay. Not only ceviche, but the Russian traditional food, borscht. Yes, it is like beef soup with sour milk, taiga, okay. So let's begin the practice. And I want you to like illustrate that you are talking with a beautiful lady or a handsome man. So you are actually on a date. So let's communicate with this person and say, hi, hello, my name, and what is your name? Nice to meet you. Yes. And eventually say goodbye. So let's support the conversation and begin the practice. So here you could see the greetings, привет. The Spanish, the English V and the English and the B has no like a little bit difference, but in the Russian language they have. So you don't say привет, but you say привет. It's slightly different sound. Even now you could practice and say after me like привет. It's in a very informal way, but everyone will be very happy and they're amazed by your willingness to talk in English. So don't be shy and please welcome. Say привет, hello. And or you may say like in more formal way, здравствуйте. I know that it is sounds pretty hard, but it is direct это, да, formal way to say здравствуйте. And it is not здравствуйте, but здравствуйте. So it's not like a хота, but there's more like English I. Здравствуйте. Те, it is like to, like те, да? So здравствуй, to. Like, I wish you to be healthy. Здраво. It is health. So здравствуйте, I wish you to be healthy. Actually, also you could see, I have downloaded the song, so you could hear it. Let's hear again.
I think we can listen because you didn't share the sound with the screen.
Ah, okay. Mm-hmm. So I think you have heard, and so don't be shy, and then we will practice again and say привет. This means hi. Oh, salut. So let's continue with another greetings. You can say good morning. Actually, it's not translated as good evening. This is similar to Spanish one, I think, yes. So buenos dias, да? День, días. So and buenas noches, so добрый вечер. Somehow they are familiar, and according to the grammatic and the Spanish one are very similar because they use verbs conjugate. So and the time. Russian has only three times: past, present, and the future. So they do not divide actually the time to the pluscumfiacto, imperfecto, or futuro simple. So no difference. You just say in future meaning, in past meaning, and the now, or by using the word now, you could say this. There is no difference, and completely useful. So let's continue the word tag. Good afternoon or good day. Yes, so добрый день, добрый вечер. As you can see, this means good day for you, kind day to you, and so let's practice with a more formal one. Меня зовут Светлана. It is your first phrase actually for today. I will give you another example. The slide. It is mine or myself. Yes, myself. So, I mean, we usually say myself. How to call it? Светлана. Actually, everyone calls me Светлана. But no, like I am Svetlana. Not I'm not calling myself Svetlana, but me call it Svetlana. So it is actually. So let's practice. Every good I wish. Tell us. I'm willing to speak with you and. The first phrase, so you can see not здравствуйте, but you can say привет, more informal one, and then it is more привет, as it is example. Меня зовут Элиса. You could see that it's Cyrillic translation, but in the are very nice. So, привет, меня зовут Элиса, очень приятно. Who do you want to try? Or I should repeat the... Oh, guys, please don't be shy. Actually, the introduction to Russian. Let's talk in Russian, and I will give you some, maybe some directions. And maybe if you would see some person from ex-Soviet, and say, Привет, меня... Привет, меня зовут Нельсон, да? Привет. Меня Александра, Ванесса. Очень приятно. So, I think everyone will be very glad. You may...
Привет, меня зовут Маджа.
Ой, so brilliant. So, perfecto. You could hear every sound correctly. It is... You have a... indeed, you have... Great pronunciation. So you do not actually you say every word correctly. That's great. Who do wants to start?
Could you repeat? Nice to meet you.
Okay. Привет. Меня зовут Элиса. Очень приятно. Приятно. Приятно, actually nice. Очень, it is very, very nice. So, очень приятно. Oh. Do not fear of the stress after N. It means that you should... stress the stress to the second e, so it will be очень, not очень, but очень, очень. So the stress will be to the e, очень приятно.
Привет, меня зовут Кван, очень приятно.
Great. I could not add nothing at all, but that's a great. Отлично. Perfecto. Maybe Gloria wants to participate. Start. Oh,
okay, I can. Okay. Привет, меня зовут Элиса. Очень приятно.
I could not at all. Correct. Indeed. Pronunciation is great, and actually your velocity, not velocity, but you said it very rapidly. So you say everyone will think that you are very fluent, and you are not like doing previous. Perfect. Simple as it is. Привет, меня зовут Элис. Отлично. So, okay, let's continue to the other stuff. I think it will be very interesting. So, in Russian, to say thank you, you say, we would say спасибо. Directly, this starts as you saved me, yeah? Not me, but you saved. Спасибо. And so here you could see like the answers yes, no, and maybe. I will answer later about why I have added maybe to our first language. So, to the first lesson. So, да, нет, or no. Наверное. It's not наверное, but it is наверное. So let's hear some music, and you would hear one of these words. So yes, I have shared some.
I'm the bad guy. Duh. I'm the bad guy. Duh.
So, which word have you heard?
Da.
Yes, it is da. It means yes. So, actually, everyone were surprised when Billie Eilish said da, even when she came to Russia. She came to the famous Russian show, at Ivan Urgant. So the host is Ivan Urgant. It is the name of person, Ivan. And he hosted Billie Eilish as a guest. And when he performed, when the music group song Bad Guy in Russian, they performed it in their cultural instruments. And the one word from total song, it was da. Surprised by how they could express the song by their cultural instruments. Нет, it means no, and maybe, наверное. So here's some meme, and let me remind you that we are on the date with a beautiful girl, and she may tell you, so Juan, let's go to Moscow. Let's, podrías ir a Moscow? Oh, so you said, no, I have not really. It's actually a nice idea, but I have other plans. So you could just say, нет. It would be like your confident answer, but if you are like somehow unsure or you do not want to harm the feeling of this pretty lady, so you may say, да нет, наверное. You could, yes, Russians are using all three words, да нет, наверное. So you say like, yes, no, maybe. And it is actually not really. So you say no. No, but a little bit unconfident. Well, inconfidently. So you do not say like нет, but you say maybe in future somehow we will see. But at this moment, not really. It is so good idea to fly to Moscow, have some stuff in Lima. So you would say, да нет, наверное. Yes, it is completely mutant, but even I use да нет, наверное. Completely interesting stuff, yes? So they are saying, we are saying, like, yes, no, maybe. Yes, no, maybe, but yes, no, maybe, I can go. He's like, no, I can really go. So, yes. So you and the completely in love, and could someone from Juan, you would say like to this pretty girl like in this photo, I love you. So you would say, я люблю вас, вас. Я люблю вас. Could you repeat it, Juan? according to our plan. I'm sorry, this, if it is your name or it is your surname.
Hi, I love Lubas.
Yes, that's correct. So here it is some hint for you. You could say, not if it is difficult for you to say, я люблю вас, you could say, я люблю вас. And if you say it very rapidly, it would sound like you say, I love you in Russian. So you could say, я люблю вас, я люблю вас. And everyone would understand you that you say, love you, я люблю вас. Yellow, blue bus. Yellow, blue bus. If you are separating first two letters and giving like a little bit of. So, and actually, they continue, so it would be very similar. So, to beginners of Russian language. So who do you want to try as well and say to this, maybe from the girls, to this handsome man, that, yes, I love you, even on the first date. Let's hear some new voices, like maybe Melanie or Laura would become our volunteers. Laura, Melanie, are you here? Are you there? Could you repeat it? Я люблю вас or я люблю вас? Я люблю вас.
Я люблю вас.
Oh, that's great. I love it too. Okay. Good. Who wants to try as well? Interesting fact.
I think they are very shy. They are very shy.
Okay. And so the date is over. See you tomorrow. See you later. And to say goodbye. We say again. Two forms, formal one and informal one. To informal one, it's not so hard. We should say пока. I don't know if you, in your language you have like something which means it, but simple пока. So we could say пока and go leave, or maybe you would. Wait until your taxi can and say in more formal way до свидания. So it means direct, it is directly means like till the next meeting. До свидания. So до it means until, till or hasta. So you say like hasta pronto in more so if it is hard for you to say до свидания, it is not, you know, it is not до свидания, it is до в. So as English V, so you say до свидания. Actually, свидания, it is, and somehow it means date. So до свидания, it is formal way, and then you'll just say пока. So who wants to practice and say, practice, and afterwards we would go to opportunities. Maybe.
До свидания.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's great. Everything is correct. Perfecto. Indeed, I think that you are maybe a Russian speaker. Are you not native? So I think that you are actually not struggling with B, I mean G, so perfect. Отлично. So let's pick another one. This cute hamster. Who is Alexandra Gamboa? So let's keep. So don't be shy. No one will judge you. So you have even this cute.
¿Alguien quiere participar, chicos? Pueden participar levantando la manito y prendiendo el micro sin miedo. No hay problema. ¿Sí? ¿Algún voluntario? A ver, yo también voy a llamar. Quizás Laura Valdés, puedes ser voluntaria, puedes repetir lo que Turar nos acaba de enseñar.
Okay. До свидания and пока. До свидания. Actually, it's a bit separating. And then say до свидания и пока.
Tenemos, we have a volunteer, Andrés.
До свидания. Пока.
О, отлично. Perfect. No necessary. So, and Juan. Here Juan, and we will go next to the opportunities.
Okay, до свидания, пока.
Отлично. Let's go to another. So, great job. Now you talk like really like native speaker. You know the difference between separate yes, no, and you know that yes, no, maybe means not really, no. So, you know, greetings, you know how to say goodbye in Russian. So study and work opportunities. You may study actually in Moscow, Saint Petersburg, I mean in Russia or in ex-Soviet states, go to the residency. So we could see some variants of the different specialities you are interested in. So also, and see more details, actually should be a query with prices and how to apply to the grant and actually to study for free. So yes, we have. Also in my Kazakhstan, we also have some different specialities. Here you could see as example general surgery and some like two variants like KazNMU and Nazarbayev University. In my previous class about the medical education, I have talked about that Nazarbayev University it is oriented to US model, so it's taught completely in English. They need like similarly to and the knowledge of A1 or 2-1 to study there. So it's not mandatory to know English, but even just to communicate and to buy your lunch, you should know actually Russian. As a in medical university in Kazakhstan, you should know Russian like to the level of B1. It's actually so here. If we see here, we have such different strategies how to learn Russian. And if you will give it a try, study like 1 hour per day, you will achieve an intermediate level of in Russian by yourself in 3 years. So also you can study in the courses or it will completely increase and increase your fluency and decrease the duration of learning. I know that even when you will, it is frightening to say like 8 or 10 years to study Russian, 5 or 6, but it really worth it. Do not fear about it. If I think that if a human have really wish or willingness to study, it can it will learn Russian in 3 years. I mean, this it is just to reach the B1 plus level. To reach as the level A2, you need some 1 year probably. So it's not like completely so lasting, and it's like calculations. And the work opportunities, I would congratulate are Espanol native speakers. So you speak Spanish freely without any efforts. That's your completely feature. And if you go to the ex-Soviet countries, it is direct insufficiency of Spanish teachers, especially native one. So when you will fly to Kazakhstan or Russia, you may simply work as a private tutor and ganar mas dineros, simply as it is. So of course you can apply to different positions. Again, you should know Russian, but without learning Russian language, you may just live as a private tutor. We have not so many, but I know like 2 or 3 teachers from China, and the one from directly from not the Spain, but Bolivia, I think, yes. And ganar mas dineros. So simply as it is, you can just having the conversations like on the platforms iTalki or another one, you can simply or by Zoom communicate with the students from Kazakhstan, Russia, and other post-Soviet countries just between your classes. So I think how to study Spanish, or students may just give you, or just practice how to practice in speaking. So, muchas gracias, atención, y I think that now Elisa will send you the test. So. До свидания, пока. Меня зовут Турар. Thank you for coming. And I wish you good luck with learning Russian language. I would truly support you. And if you want to practice it, I can just continue with your conversations. I'll give you some additional classes for freely, just so you could learn more. Okay.
Thank you, Tarar. I think there are a question.
Yes, excuse me. What is the meaning of ocean privyatno?
Okay. Thank you for the question, Maha. It's Maha. Mm-hmm. And sorry if I mispronounce your name. And очень приятно means very nice. That it is mean it is if we translate literally, it means very nice. But we use it this too. Okay? Nice to meet you. It's not as simple as in French. You could say enchanté and that's all. But очень приятно, very nice to meet you. But we do not say to meet you, so we just say very nice. Очень приятно.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you for the question.
Chicos, ¿hay alguna otra pregunta que quieran hacer? Pueden hacerla por el chat si es que no hablan fluido inglés, o pueden hacerla en español, un poco despacio, porque igual Turar entiende español. Así que si tienen preguntitas, vamos a dar unos minutitos para que ustedes puedan realizar preguntas en el chat o prendiendo su micrófono. Okay, I think there are no questions. So I want to thank you, Tara, again. And it was very nice. I think we learned some phrases in Russia. I think it was very interesting. I hope that all the people that are here now understand and know more about Russia and also the language. I want to study more probably. And they are saying thank you now. So as to say now, Juan are gonna send the test. Juan.
Yes, Eli, yes.